For those who love the crossover segment, every other car is a niche. Those sporty sedans from BMW and Mercedes, the full-size SUVs, or the economical commuter cars all seem like minor blips. The only car worth buying has the styling of something like the Cadillac SRX. Big enough to carry a few passengers, but not too many. Room in the back for a few book bags, but not everyone's luggage. And a drive that seems at once sure and secure but not so sporty that you'll do an unwanted jackrabbit start. That's what makes the 2012 version of the Cadillac SRX a bit hard to review. This is the type of vehicle that people actually buy, not just dream about owning. Starting at $35,185, the price is not unreasonable, especially if you use the car for business to impress clients, or the teens you pick up from basketball. With a solid 3.6-liter V6 engine running at 308 horsepower, yet with a respectable 2.3 mpg highway, the SRX has power when you need it but not so much power that you'll live at the pump. For this model year, Cadillac made the V6 a standard engine for each versions of the SRX. There is now a Hydramatic 6T606-speed automatic transmission with a push-button Eco option. The Eco feature reduces fuel consumption by altering the shift points in the transmission. Other additions. Bluetooth is now a standard offering. Finally, on all SRX models, the heated steering wheel is standard, and there are a few extra fit and finish options like 20-inch wheels and an all-black interior. The SRX is not known for a highly spirited drive. In our tests, we found the V6 to be capable and powerful at times when we needed to pass someone on the highway. But this is not a sporty crossover. The similarly sized Lexus RX 350 has a 275 horsepower engine, and the Audi Q5 has just 211 horsepower. But at 308 horsepower, this 442-pound crossover still felt a bit sluggish at times. In fact, we were reminded a few times that the drive is not that different from a Chevy Equinox. Even the interior styling, while branded thoroughly as a Cadillac with a pop-up nav system and an analog clock, has more than a hint of the Equinox's slanted dashboard layout, similar buttons, and even similar control features. Understanding that the SRX is not intended to be sporty. Quote,